only about 5% of people will be genuinely successful. So if there's 100 people in here, I hate to say it, but 5 of you are going to succeed, but 95 of you are going to be mediocre or just above average or below average. They're the numbers we're talking about. I hope those figures are wrong in here, but that is what we're talking about. So 5% of the population do very well. Yeah, I understand that some of them come from money, but I'm saying new wealth, people who actually go out, who start a business, the girl who spoke this morning, you know, people who've started a new idea or a new business, they can succeed. We can't teach a good passion and attitude. We can teach skills. But if you come to us as an unpolished diamond, we'll teach you. But you got to want to learn. You got to want to fall over and get up again. You got to really enjoy what you're doing and the people that you work with and that challenge, if you like, of learning. Can we go back one? What was the last one? Goals. Great, thank you. Very attentive audience. Goals to me is really important, okay? And I can tell you now that most successful people are going to have written goals. Now, when I was 18 years old out of Joey's, I wasn't thinking about goals. I was thinking about where I was going to go have a drink on Friday night. But I can tell you now, working for someone like John McGrath was the best thing that's ever happened to me because he was a great boss. He believed in goals. He believed in meetings. He believed in motivational seminars and things like that. And it was fantastic. But one thing I learned from a very early age, not when I was a student, but very soon after when I started working for John, was that if you want to, everyone wants to achieve certain things. If I came and met with you individually, you go, yeah, Ivan, I want to do this, I want to go on this holiday, I want to buy that car, I want that job, and you know, I want to get to a certain, but everyone knows what they want up there. But very few people actually take the time to write it down. Now, the funny thing is, the application of writing down written goals means you go a long way to achieving those written goals, should they be realistic. A long way. I see so many, I've got friends from school. I've got one friend from school who's been saying the same things to me for the last 8 years as to what he wants to do in terms of his life, his physical goals, going to the gym. Do you think he's done any of it? He's still the same, Matt's still the same person that I knew 8 years ago. I love him, but he hasn't made any changes in his life. And he's now 34. The same things that he wanted to change 12 months ago have not changed 8 years ago. So what I'm saying is this, written goals to me were a really big thing. When I first started, I'd actually write down what I wanted to achieve. This many sales, I want to go away at Easter, I want to upgrade my car by October, I want to go to a real estate conference to, you know, build my skills, I want to go to the gym 3 days a week, I want to get a personal trainer, da, 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 da. And I'd write all these things down. I want to read 2 books because I wasn't a quick reader, and I'm still not. I said read books because I knew that I'd learn from reading books. And sure enough, I would get to 3 months or 6 months or 9 months. I still have written goals today. I still sort of achieve these things and then sit down and go, okay, well, now I want my Croatian passport, now I want this, now I want that. And I write these things down. Sure enough, I get most of them. So have a mentor, have someone that you can learn from, or you can sit down with, whether it be your boss or your manager in January or February. Take time to digest what the company's about in your role. But very soon after, just say, look, would you mind, sir, madam, if we sat down and, you know, I'm really keen to do well in this company and I'd like to get an understanding from you, what you expect from me, and maybe I can just write down some things what I'd like to achieve in the first 6 months of my job here. Wow. Wow. I'm thinking, man, that girl is damn good. I want to help her. The funny thing about good companies and good bosses is they find good people and they will help you. But you got to be good. You got to be sharp. You got to be punctual. You got to enjoy what you're doing. They will help you as they help me. They need help. People help them, who help me, who help you, who help them. That's how it goes. You don't just go out there alone and just hope that you're going to work it out. You're going to have mentors and people along the way who are going to entrust in you to do a job. And if you do it damn good, they're going to help you get to the next stage. I can assure you of that. And equally, you'll help someone else, providing you take that path. Customer service is a big thing, and it comes back to attitude and passion. You know, I don't know what industry or what jobs you guys are going to go work for in a few months' time, but little things about business are very clear. Like, I have a policy in my office that all emails, all phone calls should be returned to that day. I say to our receptionist that there's a 4-ring rule. You ring our company, you will get answered within four rings. If you work for Bresic Whitney, you must definitely do what you say you're going to do. If you say you're going to send a contract to a buyer who's interested in a property, if you say you're going to meet someone somewhere, if you say you're going to come back to them, you must do as you say you're going to do. Very simple customer service. Who's been to a restaurant here in the last 2 weeks? 3 weeks? All of us. If you've been to a good restaurant, how many people do you tell?
Everyone.
5, 10, 15 people. Two people. Equally, if you have a bad meal or you get shit service, how many people are you going to tell? Again, I had a shit meal last night, man. The service was rubbish. I would recommend, don't go there, man. No, shit pizza. Like, seriously. Customer service is a massive thing in business now, because I can tell you, technology has sped up the way we do business, not just in real estate, but in business in general. But one thing is, computers not going to take over our jobs. They will assist us, but the expectation from consumers now is that you've got to be damn quick, and you've got to do as you say you're going to do, because if you don't, the next person will, and they'll take your job. So it's simple customer service. I loved real estate. I just loved it. Even when I was 18, I was earning $400 a week. You know, I just loved serving people, showing them property, and I'd meet nightclub owners and restaurant owners, and it made me feel something, but I just loved the job. It was really good fun. So doing customer service, like giving good customer service, is very simple. The funny thing is now, when I go on holidays, or I go to a restaurant, or I go anywhere, I expect really good service, because I give it. So I'm very aware of it. And equally, if I get crap service, they'll know about it. Or I'll tell people, which is very bad for their business. Give great service when you go into business next year, it'll go a long way for you to get into your next stage. How are we going for time, Pete? We're sweet? Is everyone enjoying this?
Yeah.
Yeah, good. I just want to finish with this. I'm open to some questions, if you like, at the end. But again, it's another saying which I love. Before you speak, listen. Before you write, think. Before you spend, earn. Before you invest, investigate. Before you criticise, wait. Before you pray, forgive. Before you quit, try. Before you retire, save. Before you die, give. It's nice, isn't it? So I've really enjoyed this last half hour. For me, it's very simple to come and talk to you guys about the challenges that you will have. But these principles that I talk about relate to everyone, in my opinion. Doesn't matter what business you're in, whether it's IT, law, advertising, real estate, whatever it may be, a car sales, whatever it may be. They're simple principles. Good service, have goals, be well presented, be well prepared, enjoy what you're doing, be passionate, have a good attitude about it. If you don't enjoy the job that you're in or the industry, it's all right. You've walked down that path, turn back, go back, and go back down the other path. And you will find, hopefully, what you enjoy doing. Life is great, you know, as time goes on, the more time, we spend so much time, guys, at work, and you guys will too. You really will. You'll spend maybe, three-fifths of your life at work after the age of 21. You know, it's a long time that we spend at work. For God's sakes, find something you enjoy doing. Thank you.